We are joined by State Representative Eddie Day Pashinski, and we're talking about the governor's proposal to create tuition vouchers, taxpayer-funded tuition vouchers here in Pennsylvania. I know you're very concerned about this idea.
Senate Bill 1, I appreciate the thought, the idea that you want to help some of the kids. I want to help all of the kids. Senate Bill 1 has a lot of flaws in it, and I can't see taking public dollars and putting them into private or religious schools. People have that choice today. If you can afford to send your children to a private school or a parochial school, you can do that. As long as that particular school decides they're going to choose and select your child. Each one of those private schools have certain standards that you have to meet in order for them to accept you as a student. But the most important thing is here the governor's taken $1.1 billion away from public schools, and now you want to incorporate this Senate Bill 1, which in the beginning only affects a few thousand kids. But by the third year, you're talking about estimates into hundreds of millions or even $1 billion. You're also talking about the idea that some of these religious schools won't have to take any of these kids and still get a huge amount of money. In Philadelphia, I believe the Catholic diocese will receive about $80 million not having to take a student in there. That's not right. You know, and I'm not disparaging the private and parochial schools. They do a good job. They do a great job. Some of their schools are excellent. Some of them have problems too. But so do the public schools. We have a responsibility to make sure we do this correctly. I think that right now people have to accept and understand what makes a good school and what makes a failing school. There are eight things, in my opinion, after teaching for all those years, that play a major role. Never one of those things can destroy it. All of them play a major role. So each one is part of that links in the chain. It starts with a school board or your commissioners, whatever you have in Philadelphia, because they're the ones that decide who you hire, how many minutes a day are you going to work, what is your busing company, what curriculum will you use. Next is your managers, your superintendent, your principals, your vice principals. How do they manage their staff? How do they manage their children? Are they reaching their goals and their outcomes? The faculty, every period, they're with your children trying to expound. Do they have the materials? Is the attitude right? Is the environment healthy? Do they have their goals? Are you working hand in hand with parents, community, children, managers, board? Are they doing that? The student has to take a role. That's why we have these schools. We're spending billions of dollars because we all realize that education is the pathway to a successful life. The kids have to be serious. The parents. Key part, the parents have to play a role. They have to make sure their kids are doing their homework. They have to go to the school, be involved, help out, make sure that they're getting what they expect for their kids. After the parents, the community. Community has to realize that a school system is the heart and soul of your community. If you have a great school, that means people want to come to your school. They want to come to your community. Business want to come there. It's the mirror image of your community. If it's failing, if it's struggling, it's time to look in the mirror. We also have the Department of Ed. The Department of Ed, I think, has to play a more aggressive role. Why would we have these schools that are failing? Why would they be failing so long? And by the way, you're talking about 3,300 schools out of 501 school districts. There's only 141 or 144 that are having problems. Maybe we can spend time on that. And the last part is government, because government sets rules, mandates, regulations. So those eight components have to come together and make sure you begin to fix those schools so that all the children profit by a good education, not just taking a few out.
But you mentioned the 144 schools right now that would be part of the year one proposal in this voucher bill, and then it would expand eventually over about 3 years to statewide low-income students primarily. What is the concern that if, you know, as this bill moves forward, as it becomes law, the impact it would have on property taxpayers if that money is coming out of our public schools and being sent to private and religious schools?
Well, I think it becomes obvious. I mean, if you're going to take 10% out of the public school funds and give it to private and parochial schools, we got to make up the difference somewhere. So you're either going to deny the children in public schools of what they need and give it to the private and parochial schools, or you're going to have to raise taxes or raise money from some other source. What I'm saying is the system right now, when you think about it, of the 3,300 schools, there's 144 that aren't working. Now let's find out why. Let's fix those. By the way, 90, 91 to 99, I think, are just in Philadelphia. Yeah. So are we going to change a system for the entire state because 4% of all the school districts in the state are having trouble? Why don't we focus in on those 4% rather than damaging the other 96%?
Well, it's certainly a very interesting debate, and we want to say thank you to State Representative Eddie Day Pashinski for joining us.